for example, transforming it into something alive. Live architectures analyzes changes in living spaces through a variety of techniques, technologies, and devices using augmented reality and virtual reality technology as a medium. So all becomes instruments of research for me to understand how the space is configured and how it is generated from electronic language and its intersection between humans. I have designed the virtual reality animations dimensioning to create a sort of multi-dimensional extension of the place, of the site-specific space, allowing visitors to travel through the 360-100 degrees space into moving plans and perspective. Fragile lines from complex architectural shapes create the impression of walking through a geometrical equation. The generated shapes becomes a window into a virtual world where the moving diagrams take over and a sort of new architectural dimension arise. Dimensioning can be considered as a virtual reality trompe-l'oeil, alive and vibrant, moving all around the audience. So a performance idea is the base of these artworks because the spectators perceive and receive a place moving naturally beyond its own functionality. In 1999, I coined the term superplace for live architectures awards and afterwards also for dimensioning virtual reality series to characterize dynamic places which project the spectator into a never-ending auditory reality. Exactly the contrary happens in the nowhere, in which static presences have only the function to receive audience temporarily. It is just a notion of space, or better of place, that dimensioning wants to probe by searching new possibilities and dimensions that the digital world, not much separated from the real one, offer us every day. The 360-100 degrees animation made by abstract geometries through the mediated reality become design and structure because the space is meant as the extension in all directions by our intuitions of the real world in which material bodies are placed. Dimensioning wants to expand the possibilities of perception through the virtual reality. Through the virtual reality, I want to put the audience into the 3D software scenario I used the 3D Studio Max software to build the whole interactive installation. Once in this scenario, the spectators are forced to confront themselves within a fourth digital dimension, a place that has become intrinsic to our daily lives and it is impossible to ignore. It's about our real time we spend virtually every day in front of the internet, in front of the media in general. From dimensioning virtual reality animations to inside geometry, double language, site-specific installation, I started 2015 and it is an ongoing project. Inside geometry, the language is a series of more than 35 virtual reality site-specific installation formed by diverse Google Cardboards, the 3D viewers for virtual reality of Google, affixed on walls all over the space or from ceiling. The cardboard installation reconstructs, through the 3D viewers, conceptual and minimalist articulating figures with intrinsic semantics that spectators can enjoy at the first look through the scheme I orchestrated on walls, like in these images. inside each Google Cardboard during the key 360-100 degrees. The spectators can approach and look through each 3D viewer containing single parts of a whole animation which displays itself inside the installation formed by the 3D viewers. Each fragmented animation, about 20 seconds, from 20 seconds to 1 minute, use the logic of geometrical language to generate random variations of meanings, so engaging audience with this process of modifying and expanding realities. The vision through the virtual reality introduces a plus valorem, gives the opportunity to enjoy the digital artwork also privately via H3D viewer, so establishing an intimate dimension with the work of art. But we can also be surrounded by crowds at the same time. It is through experience that in such geometry the language addresses the paradox of modern space-time condition, which is diluted between physical and liquid space. The spectators become blind and ultra-seeing at the same time because immersed in the shift generated by the perception of this new atmosphere of this new digital world, like blind people. The perceived locus, the perceived space through the virtual reality as no longer a tangible boundary, but instead become the medium of a visual idea, fusing and mediating imagination and reality during the process of perception. In fact, through the virtual reality, the spectator is totally absorbed into an illusory dimension, which redraws the whole surroundings all around, eliminating corporeal limits, and projecting the vision beyond imagination, so challenging the notion of architecture and exploring it as a limbo. I use new technologies to comprise its intrinsic language, often subverting the medium itself to create specific ontology of vision on objects and places. Like in this example from the series Into the Land Art, Earth Spiral, where spectators, through the 3D viewers, bow down to nature while kneeling to technology to use it to see in depth just over the ontological vision and function of the nature itself. So nature is animated by its own metaphysics and exists beyond its own functionality, like for the super place I quoted before. I experiment on new technologies in personal way on the possibilities that new media are continuously giving to me every day. And here are the references of my site-specific virtual reality installations, artwork, statement, and so on. And now I would like to show a video. It's a sort of making of regarding this virtual reality installation titled Area Between Cures from the series Inside Geometry, Data, Language that I was exhibiting at Maxi Museum in Rome during the month of April.